JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for May the 25th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It lost the most ground versus NZD, NOK, the Euro and the Aussie in that order, while it underperformed the least against JPY and SEC. The weakening of the US dollar and the yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Kiwi and Aussie, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, looking at the equity world, we see that although EU markets traded mixed, with some of them staying closed due to a holiday, Wall Street traded in the green with the upbeat appetite rolling into the Asian session today. Recently, it's been all about inflation. Remember that Fed officials have held the view that any inflation spikes this year are likely to prove to be temporary and that it's too early to start discussing monetary policy normalization. However, according to the latest CPI data, alongside the headline rate, the core one surged as well, raising questions as to whether the spike is due to transitory factors. What's more, the minutes from the latest FOMC gathering revealed that a number of policymakers thought that if the recovery continues, it may be appropriate to begin discussing a plan for adjusting the pace of asset purchases. So all this brought forth expectations about when the Fed may start considering policy normalization process. And thereby, it weighed on equity markets, and at the same time, the US dollar strengthened. That said, yesterday, those expectations were pushed back again as several Fed officials, including Governor Lyle Brainard, Atlanta President Raphael Bostic, and St. Louis President James Bullard, insisted that the surge in inflation and any further increase of it is likely to prove to be temporary. I think there will come a time when we can talk more about changing the parameters of monetary policy. I don't think we should do it when we are still in the pandemic, Bullard also said. Therefore, with some officials sticking to their dovish stance, even after the surge in inflation, we believe that equities have room to trend north, at least for a while more, while the US dollar may stay on the back foot. Having said that, investors may become more careful again as we get close to the release of the year-over-year core PC rate for April due out on Friday, which is the Fed's favorite inflation metric. A more than expected surge in this metric may revive speculation over the need of withdrawing some monetary policy support and thereby result in a pullback in risky assets and a rebound in the dollar and other safe havens. Now, tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, apart from any developments surrounding the broader investor morale, NZD traders are likely to pay extra attention to the RBNZ interest rate decision. At its latest gathering, this bank kept its policy settings untouched, with policymakers maintaining the position that they are prepared to lower the official cash rate further if required, and adding that a prolonged period of time is most likely to pass before their objectives are met. Since then, New Zealand's CPI ticked up to 1.5% year-over-year from 1.4%, but although this is a move in the desired direction, it is still below the midpoint of the bank's 1 to 3% range. However, the employment report for the first quarter came in better than expected, which may have lessened the likelihood for further interest rate reductions. Thus, even if policymakers keep the door open for such an action, we believe that they may sound a bit more optimistic than previously, giving the impression that this is not something that will happen in the months to come if the economy continues to improve. A more optimistic language may help the QE recover some more of its recently lost ground. Now, as for today's events, during the European session, we get Germany's ZEW survey for May. The current assessment index is forecast to have risen to 95.5 from 94.1, while the business expectations one is anticipated to have inched up to 101.4 from 99.5. This is likely to take the business climate index up to 98.2 from 96.8, thereby confirming that Eurozone's growth engine continues to recover from the coronavirus-related damages at a decent pace. European shares and the euro may climb higher, but we doubt that this could raise speculation that the ECB will start withdrawing monetary policy support anytime soon. After all, last Tuesday, President Lagarde confirmed that clearly, saying that it is essential that monetary and fiscal support are not withdrawn too soon. Now, with regards to the energy market, we have the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week, but as it is always the case, no forecast is currently available. As for the speakers, we will get to hear from Chicago Fed President Charles Evans, Fed Board Governor Randall Quarles, and Bank of England Monetary Policy Committee member Silvana Denreiro. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye. Have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.